Mayor Atienza, you raised the point na parang walang due diligence on the sale. And it gave the impression to many na bakit pati yung actions ng Manila City Government were being questioned.
Well, because they presented the former Mayor Atienza to testify on this transaction. And we were, you know, we didn't pass on the validity of the sale. Mm-hmm. We're just those questions that we raised will just show that there is a certain degree of negligence in failing to inquire into certain documents which should have been inquired into. For example, it doesn't mean that you know, if it's only the secretary's certificate, that there was no board resolution. Mm-hmm. The fact is, the board resolution was not presented. Mm-hmm. And extraordinary diligence should have required that you inquire into this. But it doesn't mean that it was not that there is no board resolution. But the point, the crux of the issue was on the 34 million.
Mm-hmm.
The payment was made to Cristina Corona. In trust for Basa Gidote. The amount was deposited in the account of Cristina Corona, which appears to be a personal account. And there is no indication that it was deposited for and in behalf of BGAI.
Mm-hmm.
So we just established those facts. The conclusion that can be drawn from those facts is a matter for the defense and the prosecution to debate at the appropriate time.
Mm-hmm. But are you also saying, sir, that the city government of Manila should have made sure if Mrs. Corona was really the authorized representative of BGAI to accept that, to receive that money on behalf of the company, or that's already presumed regular?
We assume regularity in the performance of functions until proven otherwise. Nandun yon, it was paid. Whether or not some negligence took place is another matter.
Mm-mm. Ngayon, sir, dun sa, you said that the money was presented or deposited by Mrs. Corona in her personal account. What should have been the proper procedure if it was something that she was holding in trust for a corporation like BGAI?
You said it. She should have indicated, so indicated, that it is held in trust, or it should have been deposited in the name of BGAI.
Created another account?
The problem is the funds became commingled with personal funds, and therefore situation can arise that this all became personal funds.
Mm-hmm.
So again, was that should that have been reported in the Salen?
Mm-hmm.
Because it was commingled with personal funds. There was no the BGAI could not claim that this particular account should be with BGAI because it was all commingled. Money is fungible.
Is it the theory of the prosecution is that Mrs. Corona misappropriated the money, and we take it to mean that she treated it as her own? Is there a way to prove that you know, the misappropriation or the treating as her own personal money?
Well, that is the conclusion that they drew from the fact that the amount was deposited in her name. And the prosecution now asserts that there was misappropriation. That's the term they used.
I'm just curious, Senator.
At bottom, it's all confusing.
I know.
Senator, just a procedural matter. Throughout these proceedings, the Senate has been asking for legal memoranda on certain issues. I'm just wondering, have the parties complied? Do the parties comply with submitting the these legal memoranda? For example, the earliest one was on the scope of Article 2. Did the parties comply as to these legal
recall,
memoranda?
You know, that was some time ago. I recall that they did comply with that. Don't ask me on the details because you know, so many things gone under the bridge. I cannot recall anymore. You know, the details of that submission.
So, do we assume, Senator, that you will be spending this? This will be a working Lenten break for you. That you will be reviewing your notes for this case.
Yes, we will be reviewing our notes. But you know, Adel, I wish we had gone to the heart of the problem and issue. I wish that the Chief Justice Corona and Cristina Corona could have taken the witness stand, so that we can, you know, we're dancing, you know, we're asking questions, peripheral questions, because unless you present Mr. and Mrs. Corona, the witnesses have no personal knowledge of the matters being discussed, and you tend to ask counsel, the prosecution or defense, on certain facts which they have no knowledge of, but they have to respond because there is no witness on the stand who we can ask questions. The best person to respond to the questions certainly is the Chief Justice and Cristina Corona. Unfortunately, they have not been presented, and we cannot compel their appearance. We have already ruled that we will not subpoena them. So that's where we are today.
Senator, at this point, I'd like to turn you over to the studio. Tony Velasquez and Karen Davila are there.
Okay.
All right, one question, Senator Drilon. You do accept that Mrs. Corona accepted the payment of $34.7 million?
She deposited it in her account in Rand Bank in Malacañang. That is shown in the back portion of the check that was made payable to Cristina R. Corona in trust for Basa Gedote Enterprises, Inc.
Okay, so she deposited to her account, not CJ Corona's accounts, the PS Bank accounts, that came out with a $35 million amount in the last three accounts that were discussed. That not that same account.
I wouldn't know. Nobody, there is no evidence, and I don't know if anyone can present evidence of how this 34.8 million traveled from one account to the other, from one bank to the other. There is no evidence at this point. What the evidence is that Cristina Corona deposited this in her account in the Land Bank of the Philippines, Malacañang branch. That's all at this point. Where it went, how it moved, nobody knows.
All right, what would you want to see from the side of the defense to complete the picture for you as a senator judge?
We would like to see that, and only the Chief Justice and Cristina Corona can testify to that, because these are bank accounts. We have no way of tracing these accounts.
All right. Thank you very much, Senator Drilon. I'll bring you back to Adele and Linda.
Yes. Thank you, Senator. Thank just you. A final question before we let you go. Kamusta yes. naman kayo ni Mayor Atienza sa kanina?
Okay. Nakita mo naman ang aking pagtanong, magalang. Pero hindi ibig sabihin na kung magalang ka, hindi tayo pwedeng magtanong ng medyo mahihirap na tanong. Yeah. Dahil lang sa ang katotohanan lamang ang ating hinahanap. Hindi ko naman binabastos si Mayor Atienza kahit kami po'y maraming hindi na pagkasundan ng mga nakarang taon. But we have been civil. I have given him the respect, but I will ask hard questions.
Your Honor naman ang tawag niya sa inyo kanina eh. Thank you very much, Senator Drilon, for joining us here. And happy impeachment trial break.
We need that. You need that.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. I'm glad you think so. Tony and Karen, it's back to you.
All right. Of course, it remains to be seen if the defense can get the Chief Justice and Mrs. Corona, the both of them, to take the witness stand. Because the Chief Justice had been saying in previous media appearances that he would be willing to speak out on his behalf at the right time. Now, as to when that time would come, it remains to be seen. Even Justice Cuevas, the lead defense counsel, was saying that they really wouldn't know if the Chief Justice himself would like to take the witness stand.
And Justice Cuevas clarifying before the trial adjourned that so far they've only presented one witness on the bank on the accounts, meaning the payment received by Mrs. Corona from the City of Manila. But he's asked the center judges to first listen.